here before you as a survivor and a testament of the resilience that the human spirit has. My journey began with a traumatic car accident on the way to the state fair last year. And I don't really remember it at all. I just remember waking up in the hospital. And I suffered a grade 2 brain injury, a brachial plexus injury in my right arm. I lost a kidney. My lungs collapsed. I punctured my pancreas and had to get rods in my spine. Shout out to my trauma and my neuro teams. I didn't get back into school with this time, but I need to get my brain back to where it was. Each small victory, I felt better. Because, like, I couldn't originally move, like, my arm at all. Now I have a little bit of mobility thanks to the PT. And so going to speech and OT helps. The path isn't easy. The scars, both physical and emotional, are really deep. And there's a lot of times that I feel lost and overwhelmed by, like, the task ahead of healing. But I don't want to just be my injuries. I don't want the accident to be my defining trait. So I'm getting back into school and trying to go for computer science, something that'll still allow me to give back and feel like I'm doing something. So for everybody facing their battles, even if you feel lost, you're not alone and your journey may be difficult. Your struggle may be insurmountable, but within you lies a strength beyond measure, a resilience that can weather any storm. So thank you for giving me that. Shout out to Dr. Becker, to Dr. Resnick, Dr. Silverthorne, Dr. London, and Dr. Ziegler. Thank you.
Hello. Good evening, everybody. My name is Aaron Weichert. I'm a 14-year veteran for the California High Habitual, and I'm also a husband to my wife, Erica, and my three kids, Elijah, Alessandra, and Abram. On October 16th, 2022, the trajectory of my life changed forever. While on scene of a fatal hit-and-run collision, I was struck by a drunk driver going in excess of 75 miles per hour. My body was propelled over 200 feet, leaving me to battle for my life. But thanks to the rapid responses of my partners, first responders on scene, and the ER and trauma staff at South Sacramento Kaiser, I'm able to stand here today. My first memory was me waking up in the hospital and not being able to move my right leg. I was then informed of the events that occurred by my wife, Erica. She told me what had happened. She let me know how lucky I was to be alive and to be treated by such amazing doctors and nurses. I got to experience firsthand just how amazing they were. When my daughter turned 8 years old during my hospital stay, the staff made arrangements to allow me and my family to celebrate my daughter's birthday together. My wife would tell me stories about the doctors treating me, and as she told them, I could see a smile on her face, and just seeing that just made me happy, knowing that they were taken care of while I was battling for my life. I am grateful to the hospital staff for taking such a life-altering and horrific moment and providing hope and comfort to my family. My family is the reason for me living and my greatest treasure. They are the reason why I have continued to push through the pain and adversities. My recovery journey has not been linear. There have been many ups and downs, and not just physically, but mentally and emotionally. The one thing that has remained constant is my motivation to push through. I have been told that I would not walk again. I can tell you that hasn't stopped me from trying. My recovery journey is not yet over. Thank you for giving me the chance to live. For that, I am truly grateful. I may not remember your faces, but you have always remained in my mind and my family's prayers. I know firsthand that something like this might just be another day for you, but you have a profound impact on the patients and their lives. I hope these stories and testimonies can carry you through the dark times. Thank you for your time. It has been an honor to be able to speak on my experiences today, and I would like to thank each and every one of you on behalf of me and my family. Truly, thank you. You all gave me the opportunity to see my kids grow, and for that, I am truly and profoundly grateful. Thank you all, and God bless you.
Got a call at about 4:25, and I looked at my phone going, oh, Kaiser's calling. Did I miss an appointment? I didn't. And I thought about not answering that call, but I'm glad I did. And that's when the nurse at the ER told me that my son was in an accident. Walking into the hospital, I remember Dr. Brucker calling me from the operating room to kind of give me an idea of the extent of his injury. And I thought I was going to fall down and pass out. The breath from my lungs was not there. Nicholas basically shattered his entire pelvis. He fractured one of his legs. His handlebars probably ripped through his body. So, I mean, he was looking at pretty extensive injuries. His bowels had to be resected, and they weren't sure if he would be ever be able to walk again. So very heavy to hear right before Christmas. Surprisingly, to my son's own resilience, he was actually able to come home after 14 days. After the amazing work that the team did, he had multiple surgeries, was in the ICU for about 8 days. But I got to bring him home after 14 days. So on New Year's Eve, I got to bring him home. We did a course of IV antibiotics, lots of wound care, which I was okay with. My background is a home health nurse, so it's not stuff that scared me. What I wasn't anticipating was the amount of nerve damage that he had. And that was something as a mom I was not prepared for. As a nurse, yeah, okay, I've dealt with patients with nerve damage. It's going to be okay as long as they've got the right medications. But when somebody's new to it and they're not on a medication regimen, the smallest things can literally set them off. I remember this one night I went to put a blanket on him and his entire body just reacted and he was in so much pain and I felt crushed as a parent. But here we are 2.5 years later and more recently, he just had his last surgery a few weeks ago. Yay! Not a day goes by that I don't thank my lucky stars. And I thank this team of physicians and nurses and even non-nursing staff caring for my child, because every day is a constant reminder of what I almost didn't have. So thank you guys. Y'all are amazing. We also want to make another quick thank you. Thank you, everybody.
It feels like it was just yesterday. I remember I was in the car with my friends leaving a party and some shooting started to happen and a bullet came through my seat and hit me in my ribs. And the first thing I thought, well, my life flashed before my eyes. I seen my son and just all the stuff that was important to me, right? And I was 19, 20 years old. I didn't really live much life. I didn't do much. And I seen everything flash before me. The next thing I thought, I was like, okay, if I start coughing up blood, I'm in trouble. Like, I'm going to be in big trouble. Everybody always asks me, like, what'd you do when the bullet hit you? I got real calm and stuck in my seat because panicking ain't going to do nothing in that situation. If I was going to die, I was going to die. I couldn't do nothing until I got to the hospital. We're on our way to the hospital. It's funny because we seen an ambulance and we tried to stop the ambulance and they had somebody in the back of it. So I got really nervous then, okay? So we're heading down, my friend's, he's running a bunch of lights and I'm like in this, I don't know, I was in like a dark place. I can see in front of me, but I couldn't hear anything. I just felt like a presence of security that I was gonna live, pretty much. So we get to the hospital. First thing I do when we get to the hospital, I try to open the door and run into the hospital because I'm terrified.
open the door and I step out the car, and I didn't know I had nerve damage to the right bottom part of my leg, like my torso, like waist area, and I fell on the ground. I hit the ground as soon as I got out of the car. Bam, smacked the ground. Best friend, he picks me up, takes me into the hospital, and from there on out, I just remembered me going into the back, and I didn't speak too much when I was in the car on the way to the hospital, but I remember saying to the surgeon, I was like, hurry up, this shit hurt. Like, hurry up, this shit hurt. Put me to sleep, do whatever you got to do, but get this thing up out of me. And from then, it was just really a long journey to recovery. I didn't get a colostomy bag, so, I mean, I had to walk to get my stomach to work again. I got an infection, so my staples got took out. That prolonged my stay in the hospital. Had to get a wound bag, had to get all this different type of stuff. And really, that whole process prepared me to help people, be honest with you. I went through it the same way the bullet hit me. I didn't cry. I just put my feet to the ground and started working and got better, right? I couldn't just wallow in my pity and feel sorry for myself because I had my son, 20 years old, with a kid. And I had to get better for him. And as I got better, working with SBIP, D'Angelo Mackey comes to my room and goes bedside with me and tells me about the program and stuff. And I'm looking at him, I'm like, dude, get the hell out of my room. Dude, in my room, get out of my room, bro. I can't even write right now. I couldn't even use my hands to write. So I'm like, get out of my room. But he kept coming back. He's persistent. And that showed me he really cared about my life and he wanted me to live. Working with people that was a part of the same community as me now helped so much. It helped me so much. But the young lady here said something, Diamond. She said the little victories. Like, it's 10 years ago now, but I never thought I was going to have those little victories at points in time, right? I thought I was going to be in that prison in my head, however I felt forever. And time went on, and I started feeling better, and capacity started clearing in my brain, and I started feeling normal again. It just took time, right? But I'm here today. Don't even look like I've been injured. I feel like it though sometimes. But thank you guys for having me. I really appreciate you guys having me. This work means a lot to me. You people mean a lot to me. Dr. Linden means a lot to me because you. Through all this, I didn't, you know, I was by myself. You know, my mom had just moved to LA. I was by myself. And the team at Kaiser, the team at SBIP was my family, and they helped me recover. So I want to thank all you guys for being there for me and being consistent and just doing the work that you do, right? That's why you ball, because it's all stress, right? I was sitting at Ralph one day, because we have to go to Ralph's work, and I was sitting at Ralph one day, I was looking at all the trauma surgeons, I was like, they all ball-headed. Like, this is a stressful-ass job. But thank you guys for having me. Thank you.
Good evening, everybody. My name is Frank Jackson, September 2nd. I was in a motorcycle accident, got hit by a pickup truck going about 70 miles an hour. At that time, believe it or not, I was 423 pounds, and I flew almost a half a block. 22 fractures later, fractured pelvis, hips. I have so much metal in my leg, ankles, broke ribs, collapsed lung, you name it. But I'm here today. You know, praise God. You know, the one thing I will say is it's been a long, long journey. I'm a type of person that I'm used to doing everything myself. I'm stubborn. You know, a lot of people are, you're stubborn. You always want to do things yourself. That day changed my life. I had to depend on everyone. I had to depend on doctors. I had to depend on nurses. And also my beautiful girlfriend over there, Cameo Williams. She stuck by my side. I want to say I wasn't coherent in the hospital for almost a week. First thing I woke up to was, don't move. Don't touch nothing. I was like, wait a second. I had pins in my legs. I couldn't move. I was hallucinating. I was doped up on pain medication. I didn't know what to do. But at the same time, I had faith. I have faith, and you know, I can say I think I had about a total of like 7 surgeries. And each time I had a surgery, it was crazy because, for example, my ankle surgeries, they put plates in, it healed. Next thing you know, I find out I had to get the plates removed because my skin didn't grow right over the plates. It was just like one thing after another, but I kept keeping the faith. And, you know, through this whole journey, I will say this. September 2nd, 2023. Today, I'm standing here. I said to myself, I'm going to walk through here with a cane. You know, it's like the first time. So it's all in what you guys give. You know what I'm saying? It's almost like it's a battle. You know, you have to think for yourself. You can't give on yourself. You can't give yourself limitations. Even though we might be hurt, even though we might feel some type of way, even though we might feel pain, you can't give in. You know, for all the first responders, the doctors, nurses, everybody, man, I'm grateful. You know, I'm grateful because without you guys, I wouldn't be here today. There is one point in time to this day, I still have some of my friends that see me in the hospital. They said I was about ready to check out. I had 5 blood transfusions. They couldn't even stop me from bleeding at first. And they thought that was going to be the last time. You know, they were actually saying goodbye. They were preparing for goodbye. And, you know, hey, if Kaiser didn't give up on me, I'm not going to give up on me. You know what I'm saying? So only thing I can say is, you know, keep the faith. You know, I didn't know if I was ever going to walk again. I didn't know what kind of life I was going to live. I didn't know nothing. I'll tell you this. I get up every morning. I do what I got to do. I do my little workout. I get in the little swimming pool. I do what I got to do. And I keep the faith. And that's why I'm here today. You know, so my thing is, you know, thank everybody, you know, and I can, you know, truly say I'm a trauma survivor. And thank everybody, you know, because it's funny because, you know, my girl was like, hey, you know, she worked on you. She worked on you. He worked on you. I'm like, babe, I don't know. I was knocked out. You know what I'm saying? I was knocked out. So, but, you know, hey, I appreciate everybody for, you know, giving me, you know, helping me out, extending my life, and have the faith. And, you know, thank God for everybody. Okay? Thank you.
During the accident, I actually severed my artery in my right arm. I had some internal injuries as well. Injury in my stomach, messed up both my legs. And then while I was in the hospital, I had a decision whether I was going to amputate or not. We decided to amputate, and it's my left leg. Doing great. Through the whole journey, some of my fondest memories in life is actually at Kaiser, the staff. Staff not only healed my physical body, but also emotionally and mentally. That's a really hard thing to do. People that go through trauma, we deal with the physical, but we don't realize the mental and the emotional part that comes about. And that takes so much longer. And so to be able to have the tools and to feel the compassion and then get through it, and then get through life is awesome. Just a little bit of my journey afterwards. I have talked about my injuries and my accident, but I actually want to talk about afterwards. I was able to go ahead and scuba dive in Monterey. I was able to climb volcanoes in El Salvador. I was able to trek over to waterfalls in Maui. I was able to look over the edge of the Grand Canyon. So much, miles and miles of Disneyland and Disney World. but my greatest accomplishments, and thanks to you all, is I was able to see my second child graduate. I was also able to see my oldest son get married, have a grandchild. We're going to celebrate her first birthday this Sunday. I was able to see my youngest child not make a basketball team, but then the next year make the basketball team and be one of the star players on that basketball team. I was also able to watch my third son defeat cancer and experience times with my wife that I wouldn't have experienced any other way. And so, and go back to work full time is awesome. I'm actually able to take some of the experiences that I had in it here and work with our youth over at high schools and the trauma that they go through. Man, that's a whole different story. I will never ever be able to experience everything that everyone goes through because everyone has different lives, experiences, family members, and just everything's different. But I'm able to understand a little bit of what we go through, what people go through in a daily life and the trauma that they experience. And so to have that insight a little bit and to be able to cry with them and show love and compassion is awesome. So that's what I came here to talk about, is to thank everybody here. All the staff members and everything you all have done. It's more than just healing the body. Healing body is super important, but it's healing the emotional part. Like I said, fond memories here. There's times where I was at my lowest, a lot of the times, right? But I was able to laugh and able to show emotions, able to cry on people's shoulders, able to hold staff members' hands when it was difficult. Never felt so lonely. I've never felt so uplifted and cared for in parts of my life. So thank you all very, very much. Continue to do what you're doing. And for those that have gone through the trauma, you guys are fantastic. Keep doing what you're doing. Keep pushing. Everyone's experience. I know I wasn't here for a lot of it. I was here last year, and hearing the stories will always help me in my life, will always encourage me to continue to do better. So thank you for everyone that has attended. I appreciate it.
I want to tell you that really you should let your scars be a reminder of the strength that you have. Wear them proudly for the determination and resilience, because it inspires us all. So we really appreciate you.
So for our first Trauma Excellence Award, our first award celebrates an individual whose dedication to excellence in trauma care has not only transformed lives, but has also set an exemplary standard for compassionate care. It is with great honor that I present the Registered Nurse Trauma Excellence Award to somebody who embodies the very essence of what it means to be an exceptional nurse, Nikki Denton. Nikki isn't just a nurse. She is a leader on her unit, inspiring those around her with her passion for delivering unparalleled care to our trauma patients.
I'm Caitlin Cohan, the newest trauma surgeon in the group. It is with great admiration that we present the Physician Trauma Excellence Award to Satinder Paul, also known as Sunny Daw, of Physical Medicine and Rehabilitation.
Our final award goes to Amber Coleman, our orthotech. She has been an integral part in the ICU Trauma Professionals Development Days, leading skill stations and teaching a variety of topics related to orthopedic care. Patients have said she puts them at ease, with one family member stating, "She didn't hesitate to come back again and again and again to show me how to take care of my dad's neck brace. And I didn't feel like I could do it at home on my own without her." It is my pleasure to present Amber Coleman with this well-deserved Trauma Excellence Award.
Hi, everybody. I'm Shelby Resnick. I am the trauma medical director here now. I'm not a crier. I swear, you could ask my cousin, I am not a crier. Then listening tonight to your guys' stories and seeing your families by your side, it just got me all teary-eyed again, because I think my Achilles heel is really that it's a spirit that can't be broken. We see injuries day in and day out.
what we do, we're trauma surgeons, and we can forget the impact that those injuries have on our patients. And hearing your stories tonight and knowing what you went through to get to the point where you could stand in front of us and join us tonight is why we do our job. It's what makes our job worthwhile.
I want to also say a thank you to Jason London. He was our medical director up until just, gosh, a couple of months ago. Our trauma medical director, so I want to thank him and have him come up.
There was one person I did want to recognize, especially after all this time, Barbara Duffy. Barb joined Kaiser in 2008 to help start our trauma program, and our trauma program opened up in 2009. And for the next 16 years, she's been a steadfast fixture in our department as our clinical nurse specialist. She has a special interest in neurotrauma, and she spent countless hours educating all of the surgeons, nurses, staff about all things trauma, day in, day out, year after year. Really appreciate everything that you've given us. She's a large part of why we became a trauma center and how we became a trauma center, and she's also a large part of why we're still a trauma center. And she's a large part why we've been successful all these years. And she's mentored many of the trauma surgeons, including myself, that many years ago when I was just a baby chief. So please help me in congratulating Barbara on an amazing career. And she's touched so many family, or so many patients, coworkers. Thank you.